Hello, people. My name is Derpy Thunder, and welcome back to Firewatch. We are officially around an hour into this game, and we have yet to see a single fire. You know, Firewatch, like the whole reason I'm here is to watch for fires or something. Instead, we're chasing after these damn teenagers. As you can see at the top there, our next mission is to go find the teens. We came to discover a cut comm wire, which we did. Now we can't get back up this big hilly mountain thing over here because, I don't know, we're too fat to climb it or something. We don't have a parachute. Not that a parachute would help us get up a mountain, but, you know, it's a theory that counts. So, we're gonna have to go somewhere. I'm guessing we have a road that cuts down the middle here. The road that we're on right now, we can't go backwards, so I'm guessing we just keep going north. Which is that direction. So I guess we just keep going up this way and see if we can find something. I don't know if the teens would go over this way. Maybe we follow the trail of beer cans. That wouldn't be a terrible idea, given that the teens seem to like beer and underpants. So, you know, just go where the beer and the underpants are. Not that I'm complaining to go where the underpants are, but holy shit, where am I supposed to go? This is, oh dear. This game makes it very easy to get lost, especially when you get up into these mountainy, rocky, hilly parts. Ugh, realize I've been arching my back, so we're gonna stop doing that. Oh, where in the hell? This way, right? Yes, okay. I'm terrible with directions. Many of you have come to know this. We discovered that in the last episode. We discovered that in every episode that I've ever played. Can I not just jump off here? I mean, I'm trying to get back, aren't I? So why can't I just jump off of that? That makes perfect sense to me. Up and over, up and around, down the mountain, searching for some young, naked kids. Hopefully they put their damn clothes on. That'd be wonderful. Sure, yeah. My allergies are being a bitch lately, so apologies if this entire video is me huffing and puffing like an old person that just ran up a downwards elevator, but, you know, I'm doing my best. I'm doing what I can. Here we go. Oh, another drop. Okay, we just got stuck down another drop. Why are we taking another one? That seems really unproductive. Two Forks Fire Lookout, Jonesy Lake, Theofair Fire Lookout. Supply drop. Okay, where the hell are we going? I guess we're going to the other lookout. So we're still just heading north? Is that, I mean, do we have any reason to go to the other lookout? Or not necessarily. Yeah, I guess we're just going to keep taking this path north. I have no idea if this is the right way, but the game has yet to tell me otherwise, and it clearly won't let me go backwards, so I'm assuming this is the only direction that we can go. Just try and follow all these signs. Thoroughfare Fire Lookout! Thoroughfare Base and Region Supply Drop. Do we want to go get a supply drop? Yeah. Let's go get a supply drop. We might find some awesome things. We might find an AK-47. We might find some useful utilities and things that we can get into. This is still 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm assuming. Unless some bastard changed the lock on me, which probably not. Yep, okay, there we go. Moss Peaks, Two Forks, Spruce. Anything in here? There's not jack shit in here. What? Who stole my supplies? Damn teenagers and their stupid stealing. It's a shame we don't have a jail around here. You have the good old Firewatch jail cell. Throw them in there and then light it on fire. There, we'd finally get our fire. We get to watch teenagers burn. That's a terrible thought. I don't know why I'm thinking of that. My apologies. God damn it, are we even going the right freaking way? Yeah, apparently. We're going off the map, though. I don't know how safe that is. Or maybe there's a secondary map. Oh! Hello?
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
Oh!
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
I'm a ranger.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado! I gotta get out of here!
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yeah!
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in! Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado. He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility. There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years. You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life. Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man.
Oh, come on, lady. Howdy, I'm the one here. You don't know that there isn't a tornado. Look, it's not a real tornado. It's an invisible tornado. These are new. These are in the Rockies. That's why nobody ever reports tornadoes. They're invisible. You know, everybody's like, we see mountain lions and shit. No, those are tornadoes. Tornadoes take on the form of mountain lions. It's like a spiritual god or something. What am I doing? Okay, so this obviously isn't the direction that I was supposed to go, right? Am I completely out of my damn mind? I just went the wrong fucking way, didn't I? Okay, well, let's make sure that there is absolutely nothing we can do over here. The cable car is on that end, so there's no way I can call it back. I don't exactly have an inventory, so I can't be a dick and cut the rope. Ooh, I could jump off. Nope, video game doesn't let me commit suicide, probably because the video game doesn't even have health. What kind of game is that? This is just an exploration game. It's called Firewatch, where there's no fire. Nothing's on fire. Let something be on fire so that I have something to do. God, I'm so bored. Okay, I'm sorry, I needed to vent, okay? It's frustrating, you know, my wife, I haven't seen my wife in forever, and I got this Delilah bitch that's up my ass about everything. She won't believe me when I tell her there's a tornado here. Look, what does a guy have to do to get some belief that there's a tornado? Oh, I don't want a cheeseburger. All right, fine. Fine, whatever, you know, let's head back. Obviously, nobody out here appreciates my hard work. My hard American citizen work. I am from the USA, right? Yeah, I assume. I don't know, we're in Canada or something. Two Forks. Yeah, I guess we're gonna head back over this way. Except now, we went down the bloody mountain thing, so now we can't get back up over that way, or we're supposed to. I don't remember going this way. Oh! Ew! Shortcut! Awesome! Okay, I guess we were supposed to come over this way. Oh! Could it be the teenagers?
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Does it?
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
That's true. I like your way of thinking. That's it. Yeah, swipe it. Swipe it real good. He just bats at it and it falls down. Oh, camera. Okay. Useful.
Well, I am rope! Flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them. In decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
You wait. Look out, Ranger, ex-lover, Ranger.
Was he a Ranger or something?
Oh, no. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad, Ned, 3 summers ago. Great kid.
Uh-oh.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Oh.
You guys keep in touch, you and the Goodwin kid?
Nah. They took off pretty unceremoniously. Plus, what's a 40-year-old woman gonna do with a teenage pen pal?
Good point.
Okay.
Anyway,
she's 40.
Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
And then we'll photograph their boobs. And it'll be awesome. And I'll put it on Kick. Alright, 1590. Why has this already been set? 1590, and is that important? Should I write that down? Get the feeling I should write that down. 1590. You can never be too careful with games like this, you know? Sometimes they have all these hidden messages everywhere and then a bunch of Easter eggs and you can't get to them unless you do that stuff. Either that or somebody was trying to guess this, Ooh. Oh, is that another map? Loose stone? Cool. Okay, yeah, we don't need that, but, you know, awesome. If I get bored, pet rock, always nice. Fossilized claw.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really. Does that not amuse you? My apologies, woman. Cache 241, map updated. Oh, I see. It's an updated map. Okay. Note, what do we have here? 61686, Dave. Guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shitheel, Steve. It's your man, Ron. I went up to check on the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself more than usual for something, something's lowsies? 60s? Number? I don't know, so I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in the hammock? I'm starting to think the Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're the creme de la creme. Creme de la creme. Creme de la creme. Let's toast Deb at the spot. Ron. Okay. That's, oh. Oh, it gave me a better... Whatever, I'm used to reading shitty handwriting. Keep? Yeah, sure. We'll keep it. Why not? Okay, well, anyways, we now have a disposable camera. So, you know, there's that. It says 18 on it. Why? I don't know. Oh, 18 pictures, I bet. That's probably what that means. Okay, so we'll put that away, and we'll be sure to save that for the future. Photograph ourselves naked when we get bored.
Sorry about snapping at you earlier.
Oh, it's no big deal, girl.
I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, ooh. I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person.
Do we lie?
Why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for
Why are you still talking?
When he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker.
I don't care.
15 years.
No, I didn't break any hearts when I left.
So, you guys broke up?
Something like that?
And you're just bursting at the seams to talk about it.
You really are very perceptive.
I know. It's one of my many gifts, along with accents and impeccable night vision.
Hmm. Fair enough.
Incredible.
Why, thank you very much, Governor.
No problem. By the way, the forest is all fucking burned down, lady. Just thought you should know that.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in a fireweed.
Oh. Hello,
I
Bush.
I want you to stay out there as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
Hmm. Well, I could look for pantyhose and bras hanging all over the trees. I guess that would be very signative of their location.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Well, flapjack?
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Okay.
Hey, Flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful.
Oh, it's so intimidating. I need to start using that now. Whenever someone hates on me in my comments, I'll just be like, hey, you Flapjack, get out of here. Okay, where are we going? Is my map even still? Oh, holy shit. Wow, we've made it down a ways. Okay, so there's something over to the east there. So, yeah, just keep heading this direction. More supplies or something. I'm not entirely sure what the little icon means. I don't think it's another cache. Oh, rope. Okay, yeah, sure. We'll do this. I love grappling down things. It makes me feel like a secret agent. Secret Agent Hank, that's what they call me. Nobody calls me that. I call myself that. Look, a man's gotta entertain himself while he's by himself, and I don't mean that in the bad way. I mean that in the fun way.
I mean, never mind. Lookouts that have come to the thoroughfare after a breakup. There was Vernon, whose wife got put away for running cocaine. Becca, who was widowed after her husband, a jockey, was trampled by his horse.
We didn't break up. We didn't choose to break up. She got sick.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
So we're heading back to the... Oh, we're back on the route. Okay, so we can get back to our lookout. No, we don't want to get back to the lookout. We want to find the teens. Where the balls could they be? I also need my lighting better because it's way too exposed. God, where the hell? I guess we could go down the other way. We did take this path. We could climb back up and take the other path, I suppose. Wouldn't completely be out of the question. Still, that's weird. I don't know. I don't know where to go. This is problematic. Oh. Okay, we have music now. That's nice. It's very calming. It is very calming. Oh, man. That's nice music. As Henry climbs up the rope to his destiny. What'll he find at the top? His destiny. We've been over this. I said it already. Were you paying attention? No. You were too busy listening to the sound of the soothing music and my soothing voice accompanying it. Look at the trees. And the birds and the birds and the trees. And the birds and the bees. That's a sex innuendo. I like sex. Sex is fun. Wow, this went downhill very quickly. Just like Henry did. With that hill. Peaceful nature. The game just saved. Saving games. In peaceful nature. What the hell was that? Did we find something, or did we... No, we didn't find anything. We just looked at the rope hook. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna go down this way. We're gonna see if we can find anything down here. I don't think we've necessarily been down this way, have we? Have we? Nah. Well, this just takes us back to the river, which isn't entirely a bad thing. Because we did... Oh, the teens were down by the river before. So they might be back there again. Nope. We will have to go check. They did have their campsite that they set up. So...
Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here.
Still,
I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Well, you did.
You're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh, yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
I can take a picture of it for you if you really want to see it. I mean, it's pretty awesome, if I do say so myself. I bought it at Kmart. It was on sale. It was either that or a bathing suit. I mean, I look pretty sexy in a bathing suit, let me tell you, woman. But... I decided on the diving suit. Where the fuck am I? Oh, we're on the other side now. Okay, so we could take this final little crevice down here, be at cache 306. We could either go back to the lookout, or we could head back down to Jonesy Lake. Jonesy. I keep saying Jonesy, it's Jonesy Lake. Which is where the teens' campsite was, right there. Right there, that little tent icon. So, they might be back there. That might be where we want to look. Or we go off this other edge thing here, which I didn't take. Which I'm probably going to regret and going to have to cut the video to where I can go back over there pretty soon. But you know what? First, we're going to check the camp. If they're not at the tent camp, then we will go over there and I will just cut the video to me being in that location. So you don't have to watch a long, boring trek of me heading back my steps and heading over there. Although, Now I'm lost. Oh, no, we climb this. Yes, okay. I can kind of tell the rocks that you climb. They look like rocks you can climb, considering we don't have a mountain face scaling kit, which would be really nice, to be honest. We do have rope. Rope might be able to help us get up certain things, which it has, but I don't think it can help us just get up a smooth rock face. Over this way? One final... Yeah, here we go. All right. Now we're back on the path. Or we should be, anyways. Yeah. Yeah, we're right next to the path. So now we're going to head towards Johnessy Lake, which trails a dish way. Past the cache, which you don't need. We want to stay on the path now. All right, this is still on the path. And we're going to go see if our damn teens are there. Jesus Christ. I don't know how long this game is. I don't believe it's very long. What? What? Oh, my.
Sorry,
my.
I don't mean to just leap into it if you're not ready.
Yeah,
she's
no.
She's got Alzheimer's, like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Like tracking down naked teenagers? Okay. Your idea of fun and my idea of fun are exactly the same. All right, report smoke call.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Do you? I don't.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
On it, lady. This is my job. We got to do our job, everybody. We had to go watch for fire and check for fire. It's probably a campfire, which is honestly kind of disappointing. I wouldn't be opposed to a forest fire, but... I mean, I don't want a forest fire to happen, but...
I'm back at the shale slide. You know, the one that nearly killed me yesterday.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to 5 Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
All right, Henry, come on. Suck it up. Suck it up, man. It's just a steep little hill. I could hike this by doing a handstand, okay? I know you're out of shape and everything. You're kind of fat. I mean, actually, you're not that fat. It's probably just the art style, but... Look, Henry! We're gonna do it. You're fine. Look, you made it. You're awesome. You're alive. And I lost the smoke. God damn it, you had one job. You seriously had one job. What happened to smoke? Oh, it's behind a tree. Darn you, nature. God, you never did anything good for anyone. Frickin' trees. We should just cut them all down and make paper. We'll call it deforestation. We can make a business out of it. I'm sure there will be a lot of protesters and a lot of people that tie themselves to trees, but nah, who cares? We'll just cut them all down. They never did anything good for anyone. It's not like they're an animal's natural habitat or anything, or, you know, they supply our atmosphere with oxygen and you know, all that useful stuff. No, they're dead weight. They're paperweight. Well, not yet. They're soon to be paperweight, but I'm getting blocked by rocks. Rock block. Damn it. All right, so this was the camp. This is where we came last time, and they had, like, sort of a whole setup. Yeah. Here's the previous camp. Wait a minute.
How'd you meet?
If this is the camp, then what's with the smoke? Which I have lost again. Fuck it, I'm just gonna keep walking this way. Sorry, we met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
Yep, that's the beginning of most romances, isn't it? Being drunk. Campfire smoke. Oh, that way. Balls. Okay, I went the complete wrong direction. Oh man, I'm so good at this video game. All right, well, we're gonna go back. Welcome back. Man, powers, the magical powers of editing. It's amazing, isn't it? Okay, so I went the wrong direction. And I found a rope hook over here, which we can use, because we now have yards and yards and miles of rope, and yards that equal miles and miles that equal yards, and definity reasoning and space and time, and it's just, this is some damn good rope. That's what I'm getting at here. So, we're gonna go check out that campfire and see what that is. Hopefully that's exactly what it is. Hopefully it's just a campfire. I don't think I can deal with a forest fire right now. We do not have enough fire extinguishers to deal with that. Or maybe we do. I don't know. Admittedly, I did not check my tower for fire extinguishers, which I guess would be a very important element to being a fire watchman, wouldn't it? I don't know. Do they give fire watchmen fire extinguishers, or do they just assume that fire extinguishers aren't going to do jack shit if there's a forest fire in progress? Because, I mean, let's be real. Fire extinguisher isn't going to stop a forest fire. It'll help, though, and I guess that's what's important, you know? It'll help. So I don't know if... Oh, 6693. Okay, another number I'm going to write down here. 6693. I don't know if these are important. They're probably not, but it doesn't matter. I'm going to do it anyways, because that's just how my brain works. You know, I take everything as an Easter egg clue. Another part of the map. Okay, good. Pine cones, good. We got lunch. Okay. Jot that trail down. Why? What are with all these different paths? This... Okay. Oh, I guess these are the actual routes. Like, the map shows us definitive paths, but it doesn't show us different routes through the mountains that aren't part of the main, like, the main trail. That's what those are. Those are main trails. So, okay, cool. So now we actually have a way that we can see to get over there. Ashem. Let's go, Henry Lush Woods. We got to report how pretty it is down here for some reason.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't. Okay, we didn't. Everybody didn't.
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Hmm.
Can you believe
you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things?
Yeah.
Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Yes. That is correct. What, do you have GPS tracking on me? I'm secretly a part of the military or something, aren't I? Okay. More pretty music. Excellent. I love this game. I really am loving this game. I hope you're all enjoying this too. What am I gonna what now?
Just go back to Boulder. You should go be with her. That's my opinion. Sorry for the umpteenth time. Anyway, call me when you find the girls, or anything, or call me whenever you want.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better. And
oops.
That I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
Hmm. Family and differences. Yeah, I know the feeling. I can relate to that. Okay, so we're gonna need to cross the stream, and then there should be a little path that takes us in to a tent down here. Oh, hold on, gotta report the waterfall.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
It's true. It's good deductive reasoning. Way to put your dick back in your pants and use your brain for once. Good job, Henry. I mean, okay, admittedly, that he didn't really do any of that, but whatever. Oh, they've been here.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Dangerous hunks?
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, are we still on this?
Clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's another one of those magazines. Huh, pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone magazine, it's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean. These girls have a full case of beer left here, a full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
Can we... Is it part of my job description to confiscate this case of beer? Because I'll totally do that, and I have no issues with that. Oh. Sleeping tent. Okay, so they've definitely been here, and the fire's still burning, so they've got to be nearby.
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder.
What could have done that? Like a bear, or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
Yeah, sure.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Well, I mean, when you put it that way, we'll just take some pants and take some underwear and what the...
Dear Psycho? Dear Psycho?
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's
what?
Not good.
No, that... No, not at all.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Dear Psycho, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake. Okay. That's me. Ah, shit. And then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. Okay, well, they've got half the story right. I did creep on them. Oops, look, I'm sorry. Can we all move on over that? I didn't mean to do that. I didn't destroy your stuff, though. That's...
Well, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
They think I attacked them?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No!
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Day 3, all right. I bet it was that guy, that man that we ran into while climbing through the cave. It's probably him. Find boards downstairs and patch windows. Oh, so we're fixing... we're fixing our lookout. All right, good. Good. Man, that... yeah, it has to have been that shadowy figure.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
What?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
if Tom Cruise had a good-looking twin...
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes I don't really think about. Tuxedos.
Tuxedos,
obviously.
As often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, Dale, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
I have a thick beard. My nose has been broken. Enjoy my thin mustache and long scar.
I know it's not easy.
Pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Steely, happy, tired. He sounds like he's got tired eyes.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you just... you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, thanks for drawing me, Delilah. I appreciate it, I guess. I'm going to go ahead and just pause the game here so she doesn't start talking again randomly, because I was going to stop it there on day three, but because it seems like a good stopping point. The twins, I guess they're gone. Or not twins, god damn it. Teens, there we go. The teens have left the building, so we don't have to worry about them anymore causing fires or, you know, shooting off fireworks, which is apparently illegal in our little case that we've been. But yeah, that shadowy figure has got to be what disrupted them, is my guess. Because someone destroyed my lookout tower and then went and destroyed their tent. Someone is on a murderous rampage. Well, not murderous, but destructive rampage. And my guess is that it was that shadowy figure that was stalking me earlier. You know, context clues and all that. But hopefully we'll figure out another time. So, man, this is a fun game. I love this. Hope you're all enjoying it too. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for watching. I hope the rest of your day goes fabulousitinously. As always, I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.